Hi all, today we'll go for study our next experiment, that is experiment number 5, design, develop and implement C or Java program to generate the machine code using triplets for the statement A equal to minus B into bracket C plus D, whose intermediate code in three address form is, that is also it's given, three address form code is given. So this is a triplet is given, first one triplet is given, okay. So for that intermediate code is given, for this intermediate code you have to generate the machine code. So that is machine code is nothing but you have to write in a, consider the, it's equivalent to assembly level language, you have to write it, that is by using move or add, okay. So multiply like this statements you would write it, okay. So here this will come inside a compiler designs code generation phase, that is intermediate, whatever input is given from the intermediate phase, there from that you have to generate the machine code, that is code generation phase it will come later. So here this is three address code is nothing but triplet form it's given it, so that is always in three address code you will be having only one operator in the right hand side of the equal to, okay, that is only one operator is allowed, not more than one. That's why this one is converted like this and it's given only one operator is allowed. So one operator means maximum you can have two operands, okay, in the right hand side of the equal to. Left hand side always where you have to keep the result will be there, then right hand side maximum only one operator is allowed in a three address form, okay. So here whatever this three address form is there, for this we have to generate the machine code, that is using, that is move or add and multiplication like that you have to use it here, okay. So when actually you are writing a seeing of compiler, that time this will be there, this will be there in terms of matrix, okay, that is will be there in terms of some matrix, okay. So here you have first field as a, that is result, okay, this field is result, okay. Then next field is first argument, okay, that is C, whatever if you are considering it. Then next argument is a actually operator, whatever operator you have. Next one is here argument number 2, that is D. So here when you are converting into actual compiler, this will be there as a, here that is, here it will be there as a T2, then here C, then here plus, here D, okay, like that for next one, that is T3, okay, here T1 multiplication symbol T2, like this. So one matrix will be there, so this matrix will be passed to the, from intermediate code generation step to the code generation step, okay, intermediate form to the code generation step it will be passed. But here directly we are writing, that is this input we are taking it and we are writing the code generation step. So this input we have to take it in one file, so okay, so we are not taking in terms of any matrix now, directly we are taking in terms of one file. So that file will read it, then you have to perform the code generation, so that code generation also will keep it in one file, okay. So total we are taking two files, okay. So two files, one is this is will read it, then one more will write it, so okay, that is the result. So whatever will write, that is the result, will read this one, then our result will write it, okay. So here we'll go for a program, that is here he mentioned as a, you can use C or Java, okay, we are writing C program here, okay. So here in main what we are doing is FE1, FE2, two files are opening, and FE1 and FE2 are the two file handlers, okay. So first file handler is nothing but file_input.txt, so here we are reading it, okay, and second one handler is for the writing purpose. So in reading, whatever this input is there, this input we have to read it, then output whatever we have, that we have to write it, we are writing in this file. So for that we are opening two file handlers, okay. So FE1, FE2, two file handlers, we are opening it, okay. Then until and unless you reach the end of the first file input. Okay, that is here, until and unless you reach the end of the file of file handler FV1. Okay, so keep on doing this task. Okay, so keep on doing this task. Whatever task is there, so what task we are doing is here, just whatever file will be there, in that file we're reading like this. So each line were written as a, that is result equal to then argument 1 operator argument 2, like that we return each line in a file, that is file underscore input dot txt file, we return like this. This is the format we return. So if you saw here, whatever is there, just now I discussed, actually it will be there as a in terms of matrix. Okay, so there we had four fields actually. Okay, that is result field first one, then argument, then operator, then one more argument. Total four fields we had, but this content exactly we have to write it in file, so there equal to operator will come. So we have to consider that equal to operator also. So how file will be there, this file will be there like this. Okay, so that is input file, whatever we are getting instead of matrix is there like this. That is t1 equal to, okay, minus b, so question mark, what is that question mark, we'll discuss it. Okay, so then t2 equal to c plus d. Okay, like that we have it. So whatever we have written here, same thing we have written in this file. Okay, so this is a file. So if you observed line number 1 here, okay, that is only minus b is there, minus b content we are writing in t1, and if you observed last one also, whatever t3 content is there, just we are assigning to the a variable. Okay, but as I told, whenever it will be matrix will be there, so you will be having the four fields. So by default two fields will be empty. Okay, because here result field is there, argument 1 field is there for line number 1. We don't have any operator, we don't have second argument also. So like that for this file, this line also, you will be having result, that is a. Okay, then second argument as a t3. Okay, so these two fields will be empty only. So here to indicate that empty, so we are writing as a question mark. So two fields, it is empty, we are writing as a question mark. So here also you can write question mark only. So we are writing question mark, okay, to indicate fields are empty. Okay, so now what we'll do, we'll read the content of the file. Okay, that is the input for us. So fscanf file handler. Okay, so whatever is there, this is all we are considering as a string only. So whatever lines are there, these all are strings only. So one by one string we'll read it. So first string is nothing but result string, then equal to operator should be there, then first argument operator, then second argument. Okay, we're reading this one. So now in variable, that is result equal to argument 1, operator, argument 2. So these variables should have whatever content will come in one line. Okay, so whatever one line has, these all things are stored in this variable. Okay, so these variables are declared as a, that's why char. So because we are writing from the file in terms of character only. So operator 2 bytes like this, some number of bytes we declared it. So here now whatever we are reading it, that now one by one we'll check it. Is it operator is equal to plus or not? We're checking it. Okay, so here string comparison OP. Okay, so OP is equal to plus or not, we're checking it. So OP we declared as a 2 bytes, and that is whatever we'll read it from the file, that is maybe plus only, after that slash 0 will be there. So by default string will end with slash 0. So slash 0 will be there, and that's why we are comparing the two strings. String comparison we are doing it. If it is a plus is there or not. So like that here, whatever operator he given, those things we are comparing it. Okay, so here we are checking for, other than that if any input given, for that also we have to do it. So that's why we are comparing for plus, multiplication, okay, then minus, division operator, then this is a question mark. Question mark is nothing but field is empty. Okay, so whenever field is empty, what we have to do it, for that also we are doing it. Okay, so here now first one will compare, that is plus is there or not. If it is a plus, so consider as a, this is our statement. If it is a plus, so what is the actual code in machine level language is, that is, so you have to first, you have two arguments. So at a time, two arguments, you can't read it from the memory. So always you have to read it in, always machine level performs one register and one memory address only, it will take it. So that's why what we'll do, one move operation will do it. That is, in R0 register, we'll read the content from C. C to or not, we're moving it. Then we're performing the add operation. Okay, so that add operation is nothing but or not already has the C value. Okay, then add with D. Okay, then result will be stored in again or not only. So this result you have. So this result you have to keep it in T2. So what we have to do? Just move whatever content, that is or not content, to T2. Okay, move T2. R0. So whatever R0 content is there, that will be moved to T2 here. Okay, so like that you have to write it. So here what we are doing is, that is only we are writing it. So F printf, so in our output file we are printing the this statement. Okay, so what we are printing is, first one move R0 first argument. So if you here, if you saw, first argument was C. So first argument we are taking in R0 variable. Then second one is add it. What we have to add? R0 already first argument it has, add with second argument. So just it will perform or not with second argument addition value. So and result is kept in or not only. Then you have to move or not content to the result. So whatever result he will give here, that is here result field will be having the T2. So in that you have to keep it. So like that we are doing it. If you saw, same things are there. Okay. So move and first one and last one. Okay, both moves are same only. So just instead of here addition, we are doing the multiplication for star marker. So like that, for subtraction we are doing the subtraction operation, for division we are doing the division operation. Okay, now we'll check, that is, if operator is question mark, that is nothing but here you don't have operator only, so that is nothing but only one argument is there. So that is complete. We saw here minus B, operator field is empty. Okay, then second argument, okay, that is also empty. So here also, if you saw line number 4, if you saw, that is operator field is question mark only. So whenever you have question mark, it means whatever right hand side wing is there, that is a one argument, that you have to assign it to the left hand side. Okay, if you saw, for line number 1 and line number 4, both are same only. So whatever minus B is there, you have to assign it to T1, and whatever T3 is there, that you have to assign it to A variable. So same thing we are doing it. So here whatever argument 1 is there, that we are moving to the R0, then R0 value we are moving to the result. Okay, so that is first here, this is the result part, this is the first argument. So first argument will take it in R0 variable first. First argument will take it in R0 variable, then move the R0 to the result. R0 will move it to the result. Then just close the file handlers. Okay, F1 and F2 file handlers will close it. Okay, now we'll see how to execute this program. Okay, so here if you observe, this is my input file. Okay, so whatever instruction he given, that is only we are taking with question mark here. That is, question mark is nothing but those fields are empty. Okay, then if you saw this file, that is the output file, it's empty now. Okay, so in this we have to write the result. Okay, so now we'll execute it. So if I executed here, GCC will compile it, then a.out, just input file we are giving it. Okay, so whenever you are giving the input file, what will happen? So it will write, this is what we'll get the output. So what it's writing is nothing but here first line, whatever was there, minus B, we have to assign it to the T1. So here these two lines are printing that one. The next one, addition was there. So line number 4, 5, 6. Okay, these three lines are doing that one. Then we had this multiplication. Okay, so that is, these three lines are doing that one. Then next one assignment was there, that is for A variable T3 value we're writing it. So it's displaying like this. Okay, so this is the output we'll be writing. That is nothing but you are getting the actual assembly level code.